Then you can put in there as well some of the measures to reduce road carnages, even with the road safety's own messaging. I have not seen prominence put on child restraint measures. I haven't heard the Road Safety Authority talk about it over the years. In fact, I've had the opportunity of being in a number of engagements with them. I don't recall they even putting any premium on child restraint measures. So I think that, first off, this is a very good one for us as media to also add another narrative to the storytelling when it comes to road safety issues. And you see a lot of vehicles that are imported in this country having faulty seat belts. And that also contributes to the pricing. So when you go to a carport and you see a vehicle that is all put together well, the seat belts are all in place, the prices are mostly higher. But the ones that have 40 seat belts, you get it at a lower price. When you go and you're doing the test drive, they'll say, "Oh, this one has nothing." So you will see the seat. Some most of the cars that have come are self-diagnostics. So you will see it on the dashboard that the seat belts, for instance, at the driver's side or the rear side or the front, don't work or they're faulty. But yeah, because you want the car and probably is even at a relatively cheaper price, so you go for it without looking at the safety measures as well. So maybe talk about regulation. Regulation at the entry point can also be strengthened so that it wouldn't be as though the vehicles have to now come in and at the car port or the garage. When I am going to buy it, obviously I'm looking at my interest. I'm looking at my purchasing power as a consumer. So if at the entry point the law says that vehicles that are coming in should not have faulty airbags, for instance, at least for the driver, maybe that would also, help. I had a personal experience, and that's why I'm sure a good friend of mine's wife is the madam standing. In 2014, when my son was born, I didn't have a car. Obviously, I was working in the same company with this man at the time. So he was after he turned 2 years. That's when I got a car. So while he was going to his at that time Montessori from age one, they would go with a taxi. So he's always at the back, but they never use the seat belt. I don't know any taxi that uses seat belt for children in this country. So when I got the car, he wasn't used to this sitting in a child seat. No, I mean, so it was pretty difficult getting him to sit. I mean, I used our hard-earned currency to buy a car seat. But this boy was not used to that because it's not part of his formative years. So he would always stand at the back because he wants to see ahead of him what is happening. And that's more dangerous because while I'm driving, I always want to turn and tell him, sit down. And it posed a few challenges for me. When he turned three,
But don't
I made a
let a
mistake. And
child
that's one of the
15,
cardinal sins that
18.
I'm happy that my other colleagues are even having this opportunity to be educated on why children should be put in a seatbelt or something. I put him in the front seat on our way to school. I know those of you know Lakeside very well, the Lakeside Estate. Even though it's an estate, you have cattle and goat and sheep just crossing the road. I've never seen some before. Yes. Ah, that's why. So there was just all of a sudden abrupt. So I had to stop. And when I applied the brake abruptly, because he was not in the seat belt, he just rolled over. Fortunately, his head did not hit the dashboard or anything, but he went down. Yes, and it was an impact. It was really painful. So I had to quickly rush him to the hospital, and he was taken care of. That experience shaped my perspective, but I still have a challenge with him. I mean, he's 10 years old now. I still have a challenge with him getting used to the seatbelt, because at that point, when he was growing up, it wasn't so much part of him. And I, absolutely, yes. And I think that inculcating in the curriculum as well would do, because at this point, even though he'll put the elderly seatbelt, because he's a little taller now, so he'll put the seatbelt on, the one I use. But he would remind me sometimes when, for instance, I move out of the house and we are, say, 200 meters away from the home. He would remind me that put on your seatbelt, because it is part of their curriculum now. I mean, some of the schools teach the children. So I think that's one of the areas as well that we can also advocate for in our reportage as media. I mean, when I have the opportunity to give birth to another child, maybe I'll do something different. But this time, this has been one of the things. And I'm just hoping that we all also take that into consideration and abide by these basic things. And for us as media, I think the least we can do for the public is to highlight some of these things and maybe get personal experience. Obviously not me, but somebody else who has had an experience of maybe losing a child to this, you know, lack of education, or having a child injured and so on. So those kinds of stories are more impactful, in my view, when you're having a personal experience, someone sharing a personal experience. So this is one of the takeaways that I'm having from this. And thank you so much.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.